parents, if your child's teacher, principal, or even coach got fired or suspended, would you want to know why?
State law says you're entitled to find out, but 13 Investigates has discovered that more schools are now trying to keep that information secret.
Our investigative reporter Bob Siegel shows you what some schools are trying to hide, and he shows you how they're getting away with it.
It's been more than a year since Fishers High School tried to secretly suspend its head football coach without pay. 13 Investigates exposed the week-long suspension, but the school still won't explain why the coach was disciplined. 2 months ago in Carmel, both the school superintendent and the HR director resigned after Carmel Clay Schools placed them on leave during a three-month investigation. The school district still won't tell parents and taxpayers what really happened. And now, Warren Township Schools is keeping secrets, too. It won't say why principals at these two elementary schools were removed from their jobs in the middle of the school year. 13 Investigates has learned the administrators and the school board signed confidential settlement agreements to prevent details from being released.
It looks like the school district's trying to hide something.
Well, what I would tell you, there are always agreements, and you're never trying to hide anything.
The superintendent of Warren Township Schools says the reason for suddenly removing two longtime principals mid-year was not related to any incidents involving children. She says the schools just needed a change, and parents should not be alarmed. But if that's really the case,
why the need for a confidential settlement agreement to try and keep things secret?
Again, I don't think we're trying to keep anything secret. Nobody was hurt. We decided that as a district, we wanted to go in a different direction, and the people involved agreed.
Saying everyone agreed is one way school districts now try to avoid public exposure. State law says if a public employee is suspended, demoted, or terminated, the reason for the discipline must be made public. But school district attorneys now claim a suspension is a leave of absence. Demotions are called reassignments, and terminations, they become resignations. It allows school districts to sidestep state law meant to protect parents and taxpayers.
Indiana law should be clarified so that there's no ambiguity at all.
State Senator Mike Delf introduced a bill a few months ago that would require school districts to follow transparency laws already on the books. He says schools have a responsibility to the public.
When you talk about the public's right to know, it's all about accountability. It's accountability of tax dollars. It's accountability of knowing that public agencies are always acting in the best interest of the public.
But the transparency bill quickly died in the Senate because the chairman of the local government committee was not interested.
I decided not to hear it.
It means for now, schools and public agencies can continue to keep secrets. Even though you're entitled to know why a teacher or coach is disciplined or demoted, chances are you'll never find out. Schools have figured out how to hide the details with few consequences.
We're reporting this story because we think parents and taxpayers do have a right to this information, and kids are being impacted by these decisions. School districts tell me they are protecting the privacy of their staff members and just following the advice of their private attorneys. That advice, to withhold facts about disciplinary action, it's lucrative. Hamilton Southeastern Schools have already spent more than $10,000 in legal bills simply trying to hide why it suspended one of its high school football coaches. And, of course, taxpayers are footing the bill.